Hello everyone. Today we're going to have a brief market recap, then talk about today's Bank of England meeting. Then I'll run through today's trading ideas. This is Marshall Gittler, Head of Investment Research here at FX Primus, bringing you my opening market comment. Well, the Fed met, and as I expected, they made very few changes to the statement. And also as I expected, the few changes that they did make were somewhat optimistic. Nonetheless, I have to admit the dollar didn't respond the way I expected. Expectations of a rate hike at the March meeting fell slightly, and the dollar drifted off with them. Now, the big mover overnight was the Australian dollar. The country's trade surplus hit a record in December, and the previous month's figure was revised up sharply too. A surge in the value of coal and iron ore exports was behind the move. The oil market was very surprising yesterday. Yesterday's data from the U.S. Department of Energy showed that oil inventories rose even more than expected in the latest week. But oil prices rose anyway. It's probably because Russia announced that it cut its output in January faster than when it was necessary to fulfill its agreement with OPEC. The supply cuts seem to be working as the price of oil for delivery in the next month or two is higher than the price for delivery in the future, for the first time in about 2 years. So, as for today's schedule, the big thing is, of course, the Bank of England monetary policy meeting. The bank will also publish its quarterly inflation report, which has their forecasts for growth and inflation. So it's a very, very big deal for the pound. The market expects the bank to keep rates unchanged and to end the program of UK government bond purchases that it announced shortly after the Brexit vote. There could also be some votes in favor of ending another program that announced at the same time to buy corporate bonds, which would mean terminating this program early. The big questions in the market are what the new forecast in the inflation report will be and how any changes in forecasts might change the Monetary Policy Committee's tone. I expect them to revise up their near-term growth forecasts and perhaps to highlight the growing risks of inflation. On the other hand, remember that the bank was seriously concerned about the impact of Brexit on the UK economy. The full impact of that decision hasn't been felt yet because, actually, they're still in the EU. I think that because of that, the Monetary Policy Committee is likely to maintain their neutral bias while stressing the downside risks to the economy that have yet to come from Brexit. That could prove negative for sterling. I do have to admit, though, that a lot of analysts feel differently and expect them to take a more hawkish view because of the strength of the economy. If that were the case, it would probably push up the pound. So my first trading idea for today is to take a view on the Bank of England meeting. Will they remain cautious, as I think, or will they turn bullish? As I said, I think they'll remain cautious, but I also recommend that you listen to several viewpoints before you take a position. Another idea, the dollar's failure to bounce following yesterday's better than expected economic indicators and the slight improvement in the FOMC's view makes me really nervous about market sentiment towards the dollar. Although I'm bullish the dollar over the longer term, I think it could weaken further temporarily, especially as US politics seem likely to remain quite volatile for the time being. Finally, on Wednesday, we had disappointing news about New Zealand's employment situation. Then today, we had encouraging news about Australia's trade balance. Now, Aussie Kiwi has risen considerably already, but I think there's still room for it to rise further. This is Marshall Gittler, Head of Investment Research at FX Primus. Get more market insights on our education pages and turn your trading ideas into action with FX Primus, the safest place to trade.